Hi, Dave Youngquist. Welcome to Last Cavalry TV, and this is the first episode of a new series, Painting Figures with Acrylics. The reason for all the original militaria that you're looking at is a lot of our painting techniques are going to be based on these original examples, and these are going to be a huge help when creating realistic finishes. Today, we're going to start with the face, specifically the eyes. Let's get started. The figure that I'll be working on for this new series is the brand spanking new Alpine Miniatures 1/16th scale Waffen-SS MG42 gunner sculpted by the amazing John Rosengrant. So I've assembled the paints that I'll be using in this first step, some Andrea and Vallejo colors. I've chosen the beige red by Vallejo as the base color for the face. It's a bit of a pinkish tone. And since this guy is going to be depicted as being outside in a Russian winter, I wanted to go for more of a, slightly reddish color. I will be using Da Vinci brushes, Series 36, size 1, size 0, size 2-0, and a 3-0. 3-0 I typically don't use, but I'm going to use it strictly on the eyes in this step. So you've noticed I've primed this figure in gray. A lot of guys will use black. I've seen dark brown. Personal preference. So we're going to lay in a very thin coat of the beige red. Generally will require two coats. And literally paint all the exposed flesh areas. Then I'll apply a second coat and we'll begin to paint the eyes. The two thin coats of the Vallejo beige red have dried. Now I'm going to start working on painting the eyes. I'm using a pale sand, again by Vallejo. Never ever use white because the eyes will just pop too much. And again, you don't have to be too fussy at this point. Just get the color in there. You can see we're just kind of blocking it in. Now, this is kind of a tough angle for me to paint at, so most of my work is going to be concentrated. There we go. See, I know, it looks like a mess. Doesn't matter at this point. But for the rest of the video, I'm really going to concentrate most of my work on the left eye. This takes just a moment to dry, and then we're going to block in the iris. Now using Andrea Flat Black, we're going to paint the pupil. And again, I just dab the paint in a little more. And we're going to be cutting this back with the base colors and some shadows and highlights. So just make sure that the eyes are and then to paint the right eye, which is always more difficult because I am right-handed, which means the nose is in the way. I'll flip the figure over. And block that in. Again, a little sloppy. Don't worry about it. You'll see how this comes together. And we'll let that dry. Okay, now that the black has dried, I'm using a gray blue from Vallejo, and inside the black, we're going to add this very light blue color, leaving just the outline of the black. Again, this step, take your time with, and you can see I'm dabbing it in. We flip over once again. Brush. So one thing you have to remember with acrylics is to keep the brush wet, but not so wet that the paint will dry on you. And we tap that color in. Looks a little amateurish at the moment, but just wait. Then back to the black, and we're going to paint the pupil and make it at the very uppermost part of the eye. upside down. More paint. There, now let's clean this mess up. Now we need to clean this area up. So I'm using a mahogany brown from Vallejo, and what I'm doing right now is creating the shadow on the upper eye and at the same time reducing the paint or the overpaint from the eyes. So it's mahogany brown, again, nice reddish brown color. We just cut that back. And you'll see everything start to come together. Now using our base color again, which is the beige red, we're going to bring up the lower eye bag. Again, reducing the overall size. So I'm just taking my time, flip it over,
tip it this way.
We'll let that dry, and then we will go back in and reduce the eyes once again. Okay, so we, using the beige red again, just trying to reduce the eye bag, and I'm going to take a bit of that mahogany brown and add a bit of the beige red. So it's a combination of beige red and mahogany brown. So we get kind of a nice warm brown tone. We are going to paint a half circle, which represents talking like Will Shatner. I'm sorry, but I hold my breath during some of these steps. Now, using flat flesh, again, it's a Vallejo color. We're going to put a highlight right on top of that lower eye bag, which will further reduce See, I slopped a bit, but that happens. Let's see what we're doing there, right there. And we're going to clean that area out. Nice thing with acrylics, if you paint real quickly, you can correct certain mistakes. Get the blue back in there just a bit. Okay, let me clean that up and we'll work on defining the eyes just a bit more. Okay, I'm going to add just a little bit more mahogany brown to the mix. Get that in there. Same thing over here. Again, normally I paint quite a bit closer to myself, but you know, we've got to film this thing, so. And then back to the flat flesh. And let's try to redefine that highlight right here, and then we'll cut that eye bag back a little bit. Hope you can see all this. Let's see that. And then this step's just a little bit of back and forth. You know, trying to define that space. Brush out some of the extra paint there. Might be a little bit dark, but again, we'll get to it. And then we'll do the same thing on the other side. But while we've got this mix of the mahogany brown and beige red, we're going to add just a little bit more right there. And then just right down the side of the nose, since we've got the paint there. Okay, now I've got a basic flesh tone, which is a very, very light color. And typically, I do like to put just a little bit right there just to help to define, you know, the eye bag that I'm working on. Just a little bit. And also a further highlight on the top of the upper eye bag. Right there. So let's blend this out. Let this dry, and then let me show you some of the final steps. Now, using Vallejo Dark Red, we're going to put in the tear duct right in the corner, keeping the paint very, very, very thin. Then using a flat white, we're going to paint in the catch light. Get rid of a little of the excess paint. Put just a little dot of white there. This is just a pure white. You see, I gotta be very careful. I don't have my optimizer on. There, we got it. We let that dry, and then two more steps. I like to take a bit of the Vallejo smoke, which is a very smoky, semi-gloss, translucent color, which really looks just like tobacco smoke. And I'm going to thin that down like crazy. So here, I'll show you this. See how thin that is? It's almost like water. And I'm going to cover the eye with it. We're going to let that dry. And then our final step is we take a gloss varnish. Gloss varnish. And add that to the eye. Now, there'll be a lot of refinement, and I will promise to get these done before the next video. But those are the steps, and I wish I could have this blown up bigger so you could, you know, really see it in detail. So you get some idea of what painting with acrylics can accomplish. Here's a gallery of my work from 2013. Thanks for stopping by, Last Cavalry TV.